Hallo zusammen.
I don't know about you guys, but sometimes when I watch certain videos, I think, okay, that was fun to watch, definitely, but was it really necessary? Was it mandatory for the survival of mankind?
No, I don't really think that.
And yeah, I guess this video is one of those videos. It's not necessary, but it's nice to have, I think. Well, actually, it might also be helpful, because today I want to do something that I haven't done on this channel like this before, because I'm gonna translate an English song, a song with English lyrics, to German. And I basically want to show you how those English words and phrases can be translated to German and what might be different in the way you would express certain things. And I want to do this with a couple of my favorite tunes you might also know. And this one, this first one, is one of my favorite songs of all time for several reasons. And yes, I've known and loved the song way before it became a meme. Africa, that song really is one of the best songs of all time ever composed by anyone. And that's not just primarily funny enough because of the lyrics, which are also cool, I think, but it's mainly because of the harmonies, the melodies in the song, and the overall production. So today I'm gonna analyze, I'm gonna translate Toto's Africa to German, and we'll see what comes out of that. Let's do that. First of all, let me give you some context. Africa is the last song on Toto's fourth album, Toto 4, which was released in 1982. The song was composed by late drummer Jeff Porcaro, who died in 1992, and keyboarder David Page, with the latter singing the verses and former vocalist Bobby Kimball handling the chorus. Yes, that's the one with the mustache who sings very high. You might recognize him from a couple of Toto videos, for instance Rosanna, the first song on the album and also another classic. The lyrics to Africa, which we're about to translate to German today, were also written by David Page after having watched a documentary about the suffering of Africans because of starvation or diseases. Certain things and structures might not be as directly translatable as others, so this might also include a few freer or more loose phrasings. The respective terms and phrases I'm talking about are highlighted in the same color, so you know what I'm talking about all the time. The song begins with the first verse being sung by David Page. I hear the drums echoing tonight. Okay, no, I'm not gonna do that. But anyway, she hears only whispers of some quiet conversation. She's coming in, 12:30 flight. The moonlit wings reflect the stars that guide me towards salvation. I stopped an old man along the way, hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melodies. He turned to me as if to say, hurry, boy, it's waiting there for you. Ich höre, wie die Trommeln heute Nacht schallen. Doch sie hört nur das Flüstern von irgendeiner leisen Unterhaltung. Sie kommt mit dem 12:30 Flug an. Die vom Mondlicht erhellten Tragflächen reflektieren die Sterne, die mich zur Erlösung führen. Nebenbei habe ich einen alten Mann angehalten, um hoffentlich irgendwelche alten, vergessenen Worte oder antike Melodien zu hören. Er drehte sich zu mir um, als wollte er sagen, Junge, beeil dich, es wartet dort auf dich. As you can see, the English lyrics are pretty dense compared to my German translation, meaning they are shorter. Of course, other Germans could very well translate a couple of things differently, but I try to come up with a fitting translation which doesn't sound too artificial or out of character, if that makes sense. In the first line, the drums can also mean das Schlagzeug, the drums in a band context. But since we're talking about Africa, Africa here, I translated this one to die Trommeln, plural, die Trommel singular, which implies rather tribal types of drums. In the third line, coming in would be translated differently in German. Translated literally, it would be einkommen, but we wouldn't use that in German, and that doesn't exist as a German term in the first place. We'd rather say eintreffen, literally on meeting, or ankommen, translated literally oncoming, implying an arrival of an airplane, or just in general. Here I've used a common German grammatical structure, a separated verb, kommt, an. The infinite verb is ankommen, to arrive, and as you can see, both parts are combined, they are connected directly. But in the context of a German sentence, we usually separate the prefix or the first part of the verb from the second one, which ironically gets mentioned first most of the time. So in the context of this sentence, it is, sie kommt mit dem 12:30 Flug an. Uhr, the indicator and the term for clock, is written after the time itself, 12:30. But in German we say 12:30, 12:30. In line 4, the adjective moonlit doesn't really exist like that in German, I don't think. We'd rather phrase that a bit differently, like vom Mondlicht hell erleuchtet, brightly illuminated by the moonlight. In line 5, Germans could get the adverb along the way slightly wrong, because they might think it rather means unterwegs, which is on the way in English though. Along the way rather means nebenbei, additionally. Another common German term expressing something similar is zwischendurch or zwischendrin, in between or in the meantime. In line 7, the English phrase as if to say would get translated to German longer, als würde sagen wollen, or als wolle or wollte sagen, either the subjunctive form with or without würde, would. Something unreal or a likely yet not really happening situation gets expressed through forms of der Konjunktiv, the subjunctive. And now Mustache Man Bobby Kimball enters with a high-sung chorus. It's gonna take a lot to drag me away from you. There's nothing that 100 men or more could ever do. I bless the rains down in Africa. Gonna take some time to do the things we never had. Es wird viel Kraft brauchen, mich von dir loszureißen. 100 oder mehr Männer or Leute könnten niemals etwas ausrichten. Ich segne die Regenfälle dort unten in Afrika. Es wird or ich werde einige Zeit brauchen, die Dinge zu tun, die wir nie hatten. Although it's just 4 lines, there are quite some tricky structures from a German perspective. In line 1, I actually added the noun die Kraft, the power, in order to illustrate a bit more direct what is meant by a lot of something, but you could very well drop that completely and leave that out. The English phrasal verb to drag away can be translated in various ways, including a more tense sounding losreißen, to pull or tear someone away or apart from someone or something else. Since the bond between the lyrical I and the person, or respectively Africa, seems to be quite strong, at least that's my impression, I decided to use this term. Line 2 could be translated in many ways without sounding too strange actually. The English term man could be translated to men, meaning multiple men, male human beings, or men being a general term for people in general. That would be die Leute, a plural term. An alternate, very well possible version could be da gibt es nichts, was 100 oder mehr Leute jemals dagegen tun könnten. There's nothing that 100 or more people could ever do against that. Line 3 certainly is a quintessential one in the lyrics, not only because it features the song's title and also connects all lyrics in a way, it's also a vocal melody that really sticks in your head and shapes the song's distinct appeal and identity, I'd say. It's basically a massive hookline on its own, and it even gets repeated multiple times at the end of the song, also strengthening the song's identity once again. The English plural term the rains could actually be translated to die Regen, and although that's possible grammatically, like that's a totally possible form we have in the German language, that's not really common to use. When we talk about multiple instances of rain in multiple, well, spots for instance, multiple locations at the same time, we would rather talk about die Regenfälle, and that's also a plural term, so that is how we would approach that. We wouldn't say die Regen, although that form exists. That's, I think, if I'm not mistaken, that's mostly used in meteorological or scientific contexts, if at all. I also struggled a bit with down in Africa. You could very well translate it to unten in Afrika, down or below in Africa, which is the direct literal yet correct translation, but it sounds strange to say that somehow. Geographically, from our European perspective, Africa of course is south of us, so that would work, but to me, language aesthetically, it sounds better with the additional dort, dort unten, down there in Africa. And honestly, to this very day, the last line in the chorus still remains one of the most enigmatic ones to me. I'm not questioning my translation whatsoever, but I'm rather thinking about the intended meaning. Since we don't have a personal pronoun here, I'm not too sure what or to whom this statement refers. Is it rather, it's gonna take some time, or I'm gonna take some time? In the end, it might not make a big difference though, I don't know. What do you think about this line? Either way, let's continue with the second verse, again sung by David Paich. The wild dogs cry out in the night, as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, as sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, kind of, frightened of this thing that I've become. Die wilden Hunde heulen in der Nacht, während sie sich immer ruheloser nach etwas einsamer Gesellschaft sehnen. Ich weiß genau, dass ich tun muss, was richtig ist. Genauso sicher, wie ich weiß, dass der Kilimanjaro wie der Olymp über der Serengeti thront. Ich bemühe mich, das zu heilen, was tief in mir ist. Ängstlich vor diesem Ding, zu dem ich geworden bin. In the first line, I've translated cry out to heulen, howl, since I associated wild dogs with Wölfe, wolves, or Hyänen, hyenas. I've always enjoyed the interesting combination solitary company in line 2, which I've translated to einsame Gesellschaft, for die Gesellschaft meaning company in this context. In a different context, it could also mean the society, still sort of related. For the third line, I've added the German equivalent to the adjective exactly, genau, which works well in combination with a follow-up line in the structure as sure as, which is ebenso or genauso sicher wie in German. However, to make this construct sound more elegant and linguistically fluid to German ears, the next fourth line also includes an added ich weiß, I know, wie ich weiß, as I know. After that, the sentence would probably continue as an object sentence with das, I know that, dot dot dot. The term rises in a context like this could be translated to über etwas thronen, to be enthroned above or over the Serengeti, in this case. And I personally think that not only sounds fitting, but also very lyrical, very beautiful in a way. Line 5's seek can be translated to ich versuche zu tun, I try to do, or in this case, ich bemühe mich zu tun, I'm thoroughly trying to do. Doesn't make that much of a semantic difference anyway. The first term in line 6, frightened of, relates to the previous one, which is a typical structure in many English song lyrics like that. In German, you could do that as well, but in regards to a standard way of expressing things, as opposed to a more lyrical or poetic elliptic approach or writing, you'd probably start the line again with the subject and the verb, meaning in a pretty standard configuration. As you might have noticed, I actually didn't do that for my translation here, but it could very well be done like this. Ich bemühe mich, das zu heilen, was tief in mir ist. Ich habe Angst vor diesem Ding, zu dem ich geworden bin. You'd basically use two ordinate clauses. However, in this case, you'd rather wouldn't stick to the overall possible phrase ängstlich vor dem, afraid of, frightened of, that, what, but rather rephrase it to ich habe Angst vor, I'm afraid or frightened of, which is a more common way of expressing to fear something or to be frightened of something. The literal English translation would be I have fear or angst of blah blah blah. And of course, at this point in the song, it's not it's, but she who's actually waiting for you there. Beeil dich, Junge, sie wartet dort auf dich. Yep, that's very similar to the aforementioned Junge, beeil dich, es wartet dort auf dich. As you can see, I've slightly changed the word order at the beginning in this one. This one starts with beeil dich, which is also possible and sounds even more common. Some funny trivia to round up this video with, since 2019, if I'm not mistaken, Africa is being played constantly in the Namib Desert. No, I'm not kidding, it's being played constantly. The player is being powered by solar energy, because there's a lot of that going on there. And all of that is part of an art installation. I think it's even called The Endless Installation or The Endless Art by a Namibian German artist called Max Siedentopf. Also funny enough, as far as I know, when the song was written, I think around 1981, and it was published and released in 1982 on the record, David Paich, one of the main composers of this song, has never been to Africa up to that point. So in a way, this all comes full circle. Maybe that was also the intention behind that art installation as well, to get the song to the place where it belongs. And to round up everything. I don't know. What I do know is that it was much fun to do this video. I might do more of these kinds of videos in the future as well, because I love to teach some German, to talk about the German language as a native German, and I just love music. So why not combine those two things? I certainly enjoy all this. If you do too, let me know by hitting that like button and also by sharing my videos with other people, for instance on social media, on Reddit, wherever you might like to do that. That is highly appreciated, so thanks in advance for doing that. Thanks a lot, honestly, because that really helps a lot. And of course, also, thanks for watching. I'm your Vlog Dave. Tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.